Morning, and I'd like to welcome everyone this to the 10th meeting of the Standards, Procedure and Public Appointments Committee in 2023. The committee's received apologies from Edward Mountain, MSP. Our first agenda item is a decision on taking business in private. Are the committee in agreement whether to take consideration of the revisions to the guidance on the Code of Conduct for MSPs and consideration of its approach to petition PE1949, review the rules concerning dual mandate MSPs, should be taken in private at a future meeting. Is the committee in agreement?
Agreed.
I'm grateful. Agenda item two is to consider the draft annual report for the parliamentary year from the 13th of May 2022 through to the 12th of May 2023. And the report will in due course be published. Do any members have any comments they'd like to make on the report? Emma, can I come to you?
Thank you, Convener. I'm a relatively new member to this committee, but I would like to say that it's really nice to read a short report.
Well, I'm glad you found it useful as a synopsis of the work that the committee have done prior to you joining us. And of course, your joining is most welcome, but it is an interesting snapshot of the work that the committee have covered in the past year. In particular, the report on the future parliamentary procedures and practices, which was very much the start, genesis, that this committee took for this session. And I think it's worth pointing out that the report contains, as indeed much of our discussion, about the iterative nature of change, that we should never consider this parliament to be fixed. It's always on a journey to improvement. Some of it might be down the odd cul-de-sac, but I don't think there's harm in learning from mistakes, whereas I do think there is harm in trying to fix everything in aspic and say we're successful on it. So thank you for that, Emma. Are there any other comments from the members? Bob?
Just briefly, Convener, first of all, to thank the clerk and team for producing the report and supporting us for meetings over the last year, and to commend Emma's observation at the brevity of the report. The brevity of the report means it talks in broad brushstrokes, but it doesn't necessarily give the full details of what's been looked at. I know we'll come to these matters at some point later in the year in relation to our work programme. One of the aspects of the iterative nature of parliamentary reform that's been alluded to in the past is the fact about making this place more family-friendly. And I'm just minded to put on the record again, there's still no particular childcare facilities or creche that's appropriate for members of this place to not have to work remotely or be elsewhere, but to be here, not just members, but of course staff, who are just as important in supporting this parliament, and maybe that's a bit of joint work we can do in the future. I merely mention that because it wouldn't, of course, be in our annual report, because it should be brief and concise, but in a meeting we can expand a little bit more, so I wanted to put that on the record. Hope we return to that.
That's very helpful, and of course the question of the creche and care facilities within this parliament has been raised by a number of members in a number of different venues, and I know those, and I will mention the SPCB will hear this and can be confident, Bob, that we will return to it, hopefully in a positive way and with suggestions for improvements and indeed facilitation of care. Are there any comments, Alexander? Do you want to?
Yes, Convener. I agree. I think it's good to have a report that is summarising where we are and not going into too much. But it's a very important report because it does clarify many of the areas that we've considered and the ones we're continuing to consider. It's always good to revise and review. And that's exactly what we're trying to do. The number of opportunities we've had to look at the code and look at what might be improved and what might be considered, I think is still very much where we are. We haven't got it right in all aspects, we know that, but we're prepared and we're willing to see and test the water and find where we should go. And I think that comes very much full of this report, because we've brought in proxy, we've brought in the ideas and the situations, and these are all to the benefit of the Parliament, but also to the benefit of the members. This committee is here to support, protect, but also to scrutinise the members. And I think that's exactly what it does. And this report gives us that information. Thank you.
That's very, very helpful. And indeed, just before I formally invite the committee to agree to the publication of the report, can I echo Bob Doris's comments about the support that we have from both the clerking team, those at SPICE, and also those people out with who've supported us in evidence sessions, bringing their knowledge to it. It's been incredibly helpful. So on the formal record, can I thank them all for that? And with that, are the committee happy for the report to be published? I'm very grateful. I will now move this meeting into private.